Firstly, I'm really honored to be going to represent India at the Olympics, and I'm really excited and looking forward because it's my first Olympics, and I'm excited at the same time as you know days are going and we are moving forward to Paris, and I feel nervous also because people are having a lot of expectations from me, but I'm really working really very hard, and I'll go only with the one mindset that this time I have to win medal for India and come back with a medal.
Can you tell us a little more about your preparation for Paris? A little more.
So since I qualified for Paris Olympics, I participated in the Stranja competition, and there I won silver medal, and then late after that we went to Montenegro. We had 2 weeks of training camp there with different country boxers. We did some sparring sessions, and we also went to Turkey, where I have sparred with Tokyo Olympic silver medalist and world champion, who is the main rival in my weight category, and I really had a good experience sparring with her, and it gave me confidence to do well in Eloda Cup. And then recently in Eloda Cup I won gold medal, and I'm really happy the way I performed, and hopefully I keep continue to work hard and do well at the Olympics too.
Thank you for the answer. Lovely answer.
Rajaraman,
can go ahead and ask your question, please.
Yeah, thank you very much, Nikat. Good evening to you. Just want to know, you've already competed in a world championship, in several world championships. You've got a world championship gold against your name. Why then would an athlete of your stature peak of nervousness going to the Olympic Games? Because you've already experienced playing at the highest level.
Good evening, sir. So I am nervous because it's not that I'm an experienced boxer, that's why you know I shouldn't be getting nervous. It's my thing, because before every competition I get nervous, because if I don't get nervous, my body doesn't work the way I want to perform in the ring, because I feel when I'm nervous my body works well and I'm focused more. So that is why, and also this is my first Olympics, I don't have experience of playing at the Olympic platform, so because of that I'm nervous. But otherwise, once I entered the ring, I don't think about outside. I just wanted to be focused and win that bout and come back with the medal.
Thank you very much. Lovely answer, Nika. Wonderful. Such a lovely and honest confession that you have made despite being a world champion. Brilliant. Next question, Sabi Hussain. Please go ahead. Sabi, please introduce yourself and ask your question to Nika.
Nika, hi. This is Sabi Hussain from Times of India.
Hi.
So Nikhat, two questions. One is, since the Asian Games where you had won a bronze medal, what has changed for you in this last 1 year or so since the Asian Games, like in terms of your personality, in terms of your game awareness, in terms of becoming a more mature boxer, and also in terms of your game, what has changed in all these months, and also about talking about your game, have you introduced some technique change in your game, keeping in mind that the Olympics would be a lot tougher and this is your first Olympics? So any changes that you have, any minor changes that you have brought in your game, maybe becoming more, not to be too aggressive in the ring, or maybe, like kind of, you know your game better, so yeah. Question.
So basically, in the Asian Games, if you must have seen my bouts, when I was facing the Vietnam girl in the first bout, I was aggressive in the whole 3 rounds in that bout, and also with the Korean girl, also with the Jordan girl. but when I was facing the Thai opponent, so I was good in the second. I started putting a lot of efforts in the second and third round, which because of that I had, you know, judges didn't give me in the first round. So because of not being aggressive in the semi-final, that because of that I had to lose that bout by split decision. So after that, you know, I had an idea that okay, maybe because of not giving my full-fledged performance, because of that I lost. So I took that as a lesson and I worked on my mistakes, and since then I came as a different fighter in the ring. And also I really had a good experience in the stranger also, after beating two Olympians. One was a Mongolian boxer, and also in French boxer in the quarterfinal. So they both were really tough, and but I could beat them by unanimous decision. So yeah, I was happy though I won silver, but it wasn't about results for me. It was about the way I performed in the stranger, and I was happy. And also I was very happy the way I performed in Eloda Cup. So yeah, overall I'm happy with the performance since Asian Games. And also, just wanted to be focused and keep performing well at the Olympics too.
Lovely answer. Thank you very much for that question and answer. You have a question from Amran Chakravarti from Reuters, the international agency. He is asking that whether you have identified your main rivals in Paris. If you have identified them, do you have a separate plan for each one of them, or do you just go by instinct? That is his question.
So, sir, I mean, I know the Olympics will be tougher than the World Championship because all the experienced boxers will be coming there, and I can't take anyone easy because everyone must have worked really hard to represent their country and win medal for the country. So I can't take it easy on anyone. Obviously, I know from my weight category who are the most tough opponents. I'll be keeping an eye on them, but also I don't want to ignore the other boxers who recently qualified from the second world qualifiers and from the first world qualifiers. So I just want to take everyone as my, you know, important and tough opponents. And also in the Olympics there is no seeding, no ranking, so it just, you know, it's all about your luck there. I don't know whom I'll be facing in the first round or in the second round. So from my side, I'm working really hard. So let's hope for the best that I get a good draw and, you know, beat all the boxers in my weight category and win that medal for India.
Thank you very much. Your next question comes from Anmol. Anmol, ask questions to Chief.
Yes, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am. I am Anmol from Khelna. So my question is that Abu Yu is one of the strongest medal contender in Paris, and you haven't met her yet. So have you watched her bouts, and you find any obstacle in facing her by looking at her matches and all?
Yeah, I've seen her game. She's a very technical boxer. She's always on her feet. And also, I didn't face her in any competition. So obviously, it will be something new for me if I face her in the Olympics. And I don't know. I have never even sparred with her. So obviously, I'll go by instincts. I'll just you know, when I'll face, if I'll face her in the Olympics, so definitely I'll just see first 32nd, and then I'll according to the situation I'll change my game plan.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Indrani,
last, please go ahead.
Hello, Nikhil. This is Anmol Gurum from New Union Express.
Hi.
My question is, I'll just go back to that nervousness that you were talking about. I think it's very understandable, right? Like, you are someone who sets high standards. You're looking to ensure that everything is, like, in order, right? Like, what are the precautions that you're taking in order to ensure that that you don't kind of nervousness? I mean, is there any particular mental training or something, but taking in order to ensure that everything is fine?
So basically, when I get nervous, I talk to my family or I talk to my very close friends, and also before going to venue, I listen music, I pray, and I play games which not let me get distracted, and to let me focus on my goal that, I have to win this bout. I have, come here to win this championship. So these things, keep me focused and get distracted from the nervousness.
Aparajita, next, please. Go ahead with your question.
Hi, this is Aparajita from PTI. I want to ask about the seedings and rankings. During the World Championships also there were no seedings and rankings, और आपको बहुत ही difficult draw मिला था. So how do you prepare to go about it when you have, like, you had continuous matches back to back, you didn't have a lot of rest time. So in a tournament like an Olympics, which will be your first, so how do you mentally prepare for it?
यस, रिसेंटली जो 2023 दिल्ली में जो वर्ल्ड चैम्पियनशिप हुआ था उसमें मुझे सीडिंग नहीं मिली थी, बिकॉज आई वॉज अ वर्ल्ड चैम्पियन इन 52 कैटेगरी. सो उस बेसिस पे मुझे 50 कैटेगरी में रैंकिंग नहीं मिली थी, सो आई वॉज अनसीडेड. बट सीडिंग इतना मैटर नहीं करता है, बिकॉज देयर ऐसे बहुत सारे बॉक्सर्स हैं जो सीडिंग होने के बाद भी दे कुडंट विन मेडल. सो मेरे को सीडिंग इतना मैटर नहीं करता है अनटिल एंड अनलेस व्हेन यू हैव दैट इन योर माइंड कि कुछ भी हो जाए, कितना भी टफ ड्रॉ पड़ जाए, आपको बस जीतना है. तो मैं वो माइंड सेट लेके आगे बढ़ना पसंद करती हूँ. सो या बट मैंने ये चीज़ भी नोटिस की है, जब भी मुझे टफ ड्रॉ होता है उस टाइम अच्छा परफॉर्म करती हूँ मैं. तो ओलंपिक्स में टफ ड्रॉ आए, इजी ड्रॉ आए, मैं ओलंपिक में इजी ड्रॉ आ ही नहीं सकता, बिकॉज वहाँ पे सारे ही बॉक्सर्स बहुत अच्छे बॉक्सर्स है. एंड सो मैं यही माइंडसेट से लेके चलूँगी कि हर बाउट में अपना 100% देके चलना है और स्टेप बाय स्टेप फोकस करना है ईच बाउट एट ए टाइम.
जैसे आपने बोला ईच बाउट एट ए टाइम, तो त्रिजीत बपनमार्श हम स्टेट्स में आपको पूछते हैं, आप अनवाइंड कैसे कर रहे हैं, कि क्या कर रहे हैं बॉक्सिंग टाइम रिंग में, हमेशा आप टाइम दे रहे हैं बाहर जाके, हाउ आर यू अनवाइंडिंग योरसेल्फ योर फन बीइंग यंग गर्ल.
So unwinding like during competition or like now during training?
Every time,
during training. So during training तो पहली बात तो बहुत कम ही time मिलता है बाहर जाने का. तो mostly मैं अपने teammates के साथ और मेरे friends के साथ मैं Uno cards खेल लेती हूँ, मैं music सुनती हूँ, we watch web series on Netflix and movies देख लेती हूँ. So that's how I unwind myself from boxing.
बहुत बढ़िया. आपको
ऋत्विक, प्लीज गो अहेड विद योर क्वेश्चन.
या
थैंक्स. हाय निकट, ऋत्विक है फ्रॉम हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स.
हाय.
मेरा सवाल है कि फ्रॉम नाउ टू द ओलंपिक्स व्हाट वुड योर फोकस एरिया बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग, और ऐसी क्या टेक्निकल या मेंटल चीजें हैं जो आप फाइन ट्यून करना चाहेंगे जो अभी लिमिटेड समय बचा है उसमें?
आई थिंक हमारा ऑलमोस्ट लाइक 90% हार्ड वर्क हमने कर लिया है, जिस चीज़ पे हमें काम करना था हमने कर लिया है. अब ये जो लास्ट का 10% रह गया है वो बस हमारे फिटनेस लेवल पे और हमारे मेंटल हेल्थ के ऊपर मैटर करता है. सो आई जस्ट वांट टू बी मेंटली फिट फॉर द ओलंपिक्स, ऑल्सो इंजरी फ्री, क्योंकि दिस इज़ द लास्ट स्टेज जहाँ पे हम यही चाहेंगे कि अपने आप को फिजिकली और मेंटली फिट रहे. बाकी जितनी मेहनत करनी थी हमने कर ली है, अब बस लास्ट के जो स्पारिंग सेशन है उसमें हम अपने फिटनेस को इम्प्रूव एनहेंस करेंगे डिफरेंट पार्टनर्स के साथ हम स्पार करके, एंड बस अपने आप को पॉजिटिव रखेंगे और ओलंपिक्स के लिए रेडी रहेंगे.
आपने एशियन गेम्स में कोटा लिया तो आपको पता चल गया है कि मेरे पास इतने महीने हैं प्रिपेयर करने के लिए. शायद ये आपके करियर में सबसे लंबा वेट होगा किसी टूर्नामेंट के लिए कि आपको उसमें पार्टिसिपेट करना है, आप जानती हो. तो ये कितना प्रेशर होता है और कितना ईजी होता है दोनों साइड, आप बताइए. और मेंटली फिट रहने के लिए आप क्या करती हो, मतलब क्या आपने क्या बोलती हो या कुछ करती हो?
जी हाँ, जब मेरा एशियन गेम्स में क्वालिफाई हो गई थी, पहली बात तो एशियन गेम्स में हमारा मेन मिशन तो यही था कि पहले क्वालिफाई होना, एंड जहाँ पे मैं क्वालिफाई हो पाई एंड आई वाज रियली हैप्पी कि मैं मतलब इतने टाइम पहले मैं क्वालिफाई कर ली. तो एक तरफ से एक जो स्ट्रेस होता है कि जितना क्लोज हम ओलंपिक से पहले क्वालिफाई होंगे हमारे पास ज़्यादा टाइम नहीं रहेगा प्रिपरेशन करने के लिए, और हमें जिस चीज़ पर काम करना है उस चीज़ पर हमें उतना टाइम नहीं मिलेगा काम करने के लिए. तो वो सब चीज़ों से मतलब टाइम सेव हुआ है. तो उसके बाद में एशियन गेम्स के बाद जब मैं क्वालिफाई हुई थी तो हमारा एक कोचेस सब मिलके एक प्लान बनाया था कि पेरिस से पहले इतना कंपटीशन खेलना है और हमारा इतना एक्सपोजर मिलना है कि वो कंट्री में जाके इनको स्पारिंग करवानी है बॉक्सर्स के साथ. और प्लान के अकॉर्डिंगली सब कुछ हुआ है, तो अभी तक सब सही गया है प्लान के अकॉर्डिंगली. और रही बात मतलब नेगेटिव चीज़ तो कुछ है नहीं ऐसे कि हम पहले क्वालिफाई कर लिए. ज़्यादा तो मतलब फ़ायदा ही हुआ है कि जितना जल्दी हमने क्वालिफाई किया उतना हमारे पास प्रिपरेशन के लिए ज़्यादा टाइम मिल गया. तो वही चीज़ को माइंड में लेके हमने उस हिसाब से पेरिस की तैयारी की है, एंड बस अभी लास्ट में कुछ दिन रह गए और बस अपना पूरा 100% दे के पेरिस की तैयारी कर रहे हैं बस.
बस एक लास्ट सवाल, आपने वर्ल्ड चैम्पियनशिप में अभी आप पेरिस के लिए तैयारी कर रहे हैं, इतना सारा बिलियन पीपल होपिंग कि आप मेडल जीते हैं, तो हाउ हैज लाइफ चेंज इन द लास्ट 3 इयर्स, 3 साल में आपकी जिंदगी कैसा बदला है, थोड़ा बताइए.
जिंदगी सर, आई मीन कभी सोचा नहीं था ऐसा कि एक लड़की जो एज ए चैलेंजर जानी जाती थी आज वो फेस ऑफ इंडियन बॉक्सिंग हो गई है. सो मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है कि मैंने मतलब ये चीज़ देखने को मिल रही है. तो आई फील ब्लेस्ड एंड ग्रेटफुल कि ऊपर वाले ने मुझे इतना काबिल बनाया है कि मैंने जो मेरा सपना था वर्ल्ड चैम्पियन बनने का वो मैं एक बार नहीं दो बार बनी हूँ. और बट अभी जर्नी ख़त्म नहीं हुई, इट्स नॉट दी एंड. एज आई सेड माई अल्टीमेट ड्रीम इज़ टू विन एन ओलंपिक मेडल, एंड होपफुली अभी कुछ दिन रह गए पेरिस ओलंपिक्स के लिए, होपफुली मैं वो भी सपना पूरा करूँ. और बस वो पूरा करने के बाद मैं तब बोल सकती हूँ कि जो मैंने चाहा वो सब कुछ मैंने किया है. तो आई एम जस्ट लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड फॉर इट.